Welcome back, everyone. In this last video about the equilibrium constant lab, I want to discuss the actual experimental steps, because there are two types of solutions that you need to make that use very similar reagents. I will differentiate them here by using a red color for the standard solution and a blue color for the test solutions. The data will only need to be recorded on page 9 during the day of the experiment. The first part of the lab is to make all the solutions you will need today. The recipe for the standard solutions are in part B and table 3 of your lab procedure. The recipe for the test mixtures are in table 2. Make all these solutions in test tubes. Mix them with a stirring rod. Now, take the standard and blank solutions to a spectrophotometer, and after blanking or zeroing the spectrophotometer, measure the absorbance of all the standard solutions. Record those in the absorbance column in the table titled Calibration Curve Data on top of page 9. At the same time, have your partner calculate the equilibrium concentration of the standard solutions and record those in the FeSCN2+ column next to the standard absorbance values. If you don't remember how to calculate the concentration of the complex ion in the standard solutions, refer to video 2. Plot these values in Excel. Remember that the x-axis is concentration and the y-axis is absorbance. Show the line equation and r-squared values. The r-squared must be 95% or better, otherwise you will have to repeat making the standard solutions. Show the plot to your instructor. Once your plot is approved, take your test mixtures, which you made earlier, and measure their absorbance values. Record these values in the table at the bottom of page 9. The table has the title Test Mixtures. If you have time, use the epsilon value that you get from your standard curve to calculate the concentration of the complex ion in your test mixtures. Check your data with your instructor. That's the end of the experiment. Now I will discuss how to use the spectrophotometer. A schematic of the inside of the spec is shown here. As you can see, there is a light source or lamp which generates light of all wavelengths. A monochromator selects a specific wavelength of interest where you will make your observation. The light with the chosen wavelength then passes through the sample, which is placed inside a cuvette. The light comes out and is converted into a digital output reading of the absorbance value. The spectrophotometer you will use is called the Spec 200. The blue cover can be opened to reveal the sample compartment shown here. The controls on the spec are shown here with all the different knobs and buttons. The steps on how to use the Spec 200 are written on the right. It is important that you start the spec at the beginning of the lab, so that the lamp has time to warm up. Note that before using the spec for measuring your solution's absorbance, you must first blank your spec. Blanking is similar to when you tear your balance before weighing something. To blank, you will need a blank solution, which is described in your lab procedure. When using the spec, you will pour your sample from the test tube into a cuvette until about half the height of the cuvette as shown here. Note that the cuvette is shaped like a test tube, so make sure you distinguish the two. Wipe the outside of the cuvette with a Kim wipe, which is shown here. Make sure not to use a paper towel, as they will introduce lint and scratches to the cuvette. Put the cuvette into the cuvette holder, as shown here. Record the absorbance you see on the screen. Lastly, I will discuss some of the equipment and safety procedure related to this lab. You will need to check out some equipment from the stock room. Please confirm with your instructor, as sometimes these equipment may already be available in your lab. For cleanup and safety, since all the iron solutions contain nitric acid in them, you must dispose of your solutions in the chemical waste container in the lab. No solution should be discarded in the sink. This is the end of the equilibrium constant lab instruction. If you have any further questions, don't forget to ask while we discuss the lab during the lab day.